Welcome back, Pajama Scientists! Today we've got another super cool experiment that you can do at home in your pajamas. What you'll need to do the experiment today is a glass, some pens or markers, some paper, and some water. But be careful. Make sure the glass that you choose has straight sides. If you choose a glass like this with round sides, it's not going to work. Make sure your glass is transparent, because what we're doing today is checking if air and water can change what you see on the other side of a glass. To start the experiment, we're going to see what happens when we look through a glass that's filled only with air. On your paper, with your pencil, you can draw a small picture or an arrow. My arrow is pointing to the right. When I put my arrow behind the glass, it looks the same. Now, fill the glass with water. What do you think will happen now when we put the arrow behind the glass full of water? Pause the video and write a hypothesis. All right, let's try it out. I've raised my glass up a little bit so that you can see it easier on the screen. I have my arrow here pointing to the right, and I'm going to pass it behind the glass. Which direction is the arrow pointing? Now it's pointing to the left. Why does this happen? What happens if you write a word on your paper? For example, hello. The letters are reversed, and we can't read them. This means that if we draw the letters backwards from the beginning, it's like a secret code that you can only read with the help of the water. Why does this happen? Because of the curve of the glass and the water inside, light rays that enter the glass continue in the same direction and come out the other side. This means that an image will end up inverted and looks backwards when we view it through the water. This doesn't happen when we have air in the glass. We can use this clever science trick to write secret messages to each other. What messages can you invent with backwards letters? Or try drawing some pictures and see what happens to them in the water. Have fun experimenting and post your results in the comments below. Cheers!